What's going on, YouTube? Just doing a little video showcasing all my contractors type hats. I got them laid out for the specific regions they are effective in. That being, I got wooded areas next to the wooded areas, and then I have on the left over here, the first two are transitional type patterns. I don't have any desert variants in the contractor hat, mainly because I don't live in a desert type area. I live in a temperate deciduous woodland area, so most of the time the greens is what I'll be wearing if I wanted to wear anything that blends in. And then fall and winter months, the transitional patterns work very well. Just showcasing all a couple of things that I have. Thinking about in the future, talking about mixing up your camo if you wanted to just go out in the woods with all camis on and play around, how mixing up your camo could be more effective than just going out and just all one set. Just a quick video, I mean. In the comments or whatever, tell me what you'd like to see. I mean, I got a ton of stuff in the closet. Most of it's US patterns, some of it's foreign patterns, some of it's from Vietnam, some of it's present day stuff. Let me think. I have a lot of civilian patterns too, like that TruSpec hat there, the third one from the left that looks like Marpat. It's a civilian version of Marpat. Digital woodland. I got just a bunch of stuff. I mean, if you guys want to see some comparing and contrasting of certain uniforms, I'm working up on building what I call urban slash tactical camo, I guess is what you could call it, which is more stuff like I would consider UCP or ABU or the NWU ones, type ones, as more of like a tactical slash urban slash, I don't know, law enforcement. Really, the only thing I could see you wearing that in is if you were like an airsofter or something and you're doing an Op 4 type exercise, or not exercise, but Op 4 type game, where one force will be in, I don't know, holding down the fort in a warehouse or something, you know, and you have an outside force trying to come in. That's about the only place where I could see people wearing what I considered tactical slash urban camo, but that's besides the point. Yeah, just leave a comment down below or whatnot. Give me some ideas for future videos. I don't have a cameraman to help me film these things, and it's very rare that my wife can come out into the woods with me, so I can't really do legit camo tests to where I'm just in the background. And even if I did do tests like that, I probably pretty much wouldn't be hiding being concealed or anything, because a really good test for a camouflage is just to be out in the open. Out in the open with your intended environment you want to blend into in the background, like just standing in front of a tree line or something, and see how well the pattern breaks up your outline or how well it blends in. Because using some concealment will always make it harder to find them, because you're breaking up the human outline, which the human brain is kind of programmed to spot the outlines of the human body or faces. It's pretty much, if I did do camo tests like that, I'd pretty much not really conceal myself. I mean, I might get down in the prone position, or I might get into a kneeling position, but I wouldn't go way out into the thickets part and have you try to find me, because odds are you're not going to find me on a screen especially. But before I close out the video, I'll just list off the names of the patterns right quick. I have all these patterns as tops. I don't have every single one with bottoms though, with pants. Okay, so first off, we got multicam, ATAX, IX. This one is Woodland Digital, Multicam Tropic. Really like that one here in Tennessee. ATAX, FGX. That one's really good. From just a little bit of testing I did at my mother-in-law's house on bushes and stuff. Camera doesn't show it, but it's you might be able to see it on camera, but that's actually a little bit more vibrant green than that is. That's more darker drabs, darker green drab, you know. It's I don't know how to say it. It's not as vibrant as that one, but this one looks like it'd do well in deciduous areas where the leaves are not as dark as, say, pine needles and stuff. And over here we have the discontinued ATAX FG, which was one of my favorites. Anyways, just leave a comment of anything you guys would like to see. Pretty much have you just film at home or pack out somewhere and do tests and stuff myself, but I would like to be able to get a cameraman to help me actually to where I could put on some camis and actually test these out with a human silhouette behind them instead of just draping them somewhere. Thank you for watching. Burkhart Miltech signing out.